So we have our object diagram started, and right now these objects are just kind of floating around. We haven't really talked about how they might be interconnected. So let's add some connections, or if we're going to use the more formal term, we'll say let's add some relationships. The relationships that we're going to add are going to be ones that we've borrowed from UML, and those are the contains relationship and the kind of or a kind of relationship. And these are also known by other names. For instance, contains might be known as part of, and a kind of might also be known as is a type of, and there's other variations too. So what do these mean? Let's start with the contains relationship. Like it sounds, a contains relationship is representative of when an object contains another object. If we think about the world object, it contains a robot, it contains an alien, has a background, it also has a dialogue bubble and the badge here, but we're going to leave those out for now. So in our diagram, let's create some relationships between the world and the robot, the alien, and the background. So I'm going to go ahead and move some things around just to make some extra space. And to represent the contains relationship, we'll draw arrows from the world object to the objects that it contains and label them as contains relationships. Pay close attention to the direction of the arrows. For these relationships, it's pointing from the world to the robot, to the alien, and to the background. And the reason that it points in this direction is it allows us to read the relationship by just following the arrow. Now, we could also say that the app contains each of the objects in this diagram, but if I'm going to add an arrow for every single object in our diagram, it could get a little hard to follow. So to keep our diagram simple, we just want to add the contains relationships from the app to the most high-level objects. By high level, I mean objects that are bigger in the sense that they have more complexity about them. So for instance, the world object is at a higher level than the alien object in the sense that it probably has more functionality contained within it. Another way to think about it is that the world probably plays a bigger role as part of the app than the alien does. In general, you want to keep this going from the most high level object, like in this case, the alien adventure, to the lower level objects. So, for instance, an alien adventure consists or contains a world contains a robot can contain a badge, and we can add a relationship for that later. Now, the distinctions that we're making here and these relationships that we're adding, again, they're completely up to you. Where I'm using a contains relationship between the world and the alien, you might use something else, or you might not even have a relationship at all. Or, you know, where I'm labeling this as a contains relationship, I might not even have that. I might even remove alien adventure because the world is kind of the most high-level object, and you know, by the title here, we know that we're talking about the alien adventure app. But again, it's just personal preference. You can do whatever you want to. So moving on, let's talk about the other relationship, the kind of relationship. This is one of my favorites. It's used to describe objects that have similarities, and it also involves a little bit of abstract thinking. For instance, let's think about the alien and the robot. They're actually pretty similar. The robot and the alien can animate. We saw that the robot could move across the screen and the alien's animating right now. And they're both able to speak to each other. So, in a sense, they're a little bit like actors in a play. Now, this is the abstract part. If the aliens and the robot are like actors in a play, then why not add an object to our diagram that represents an actor? I mean, that sounds pretty good to me. An actor is an object that can be animated and participates in discussions. And just like we said, both the alien and the robot are kinds of actors. And that's how we'll add this kind of relationship. We'll start by adding an actor to the diagram, and then we'll add relationships from the alien to the actor because an alien is a kind of actor, and from the robot to the actor because the robot is a kind of actor. And I hope you've noticed that for these kind of relationships, the direction of the arrows again. We're going from the alien to the actor, so it reads very naturally, an alien is a kind of actor. Now we can take this one step further. We can simplify our diagram and say that the world contains actors and then get rid of the arrows that we had from the world to the robot and from the world to the alien. So I'll give you just a second to let that soak in. The world contains actors, and the actors can be robots or aliens. The world also contains a background, or that's what we have so far.